At the age of 62, a woman is expected to be a grandmother. At such age, her children should be caring for her in appreciation of the years she gave nurturing them. So as Nigeria marks her 62nd independence, will it be cliche to say, what have you done for your country?
For the entertainment industry, which has become humongous, they can proudly beat their drums and say a lot. Nollywood, Niger music, fashion and subculture have changed the narrative about Nigeria globally. The Nigerian brand is stronger now because of the entertainment industry. It's now Niger to the world.
So in the spirit of Nigeria's 62nd independence celebration, we are proudly repping Niger with our green and white attire right here.
Yeah, and on the show, you get to see how Nollywood is repping Niger in the diaspora. Niger movies have been featuring in Hollywood at the film festival tagged Nollywood in Hollywood. You'll get to see the highlights shortly.
We will also be featuring a rather unique event, a beauty pageant that was not about looks. I guess that will make you go, okay, well, wait for it. It's an NTA TV enterprise in collaboration with SRTV, organized a beauty pageant in search of a different kind of beauty.
And there is also this talk about dressing for the season. What should you be wearing, I mean, in this cool and cozy weather that we've had for weeks now? Wait for the top 5 fashion must-haves for the rainy season. Welcome to the Independence edition of your favorite entertainment show on the Nigerian Television Authority. This is the Nigerian girl. They call me Ekemini Williams.
I'm the Niger guy, Butu Miller, here.
People don't know anything about the continent, about Nigeria, about Hollywood.
Some of their presentation was like a copyright.
The land is not level.
All right. If you're ready, we're ready.
It has been confirmed. Chioma is the love of Davido's life.
You're the one I want to. Before my liver start to fail.
This is the talk going round on social media after this video clip of the 30BG leader Davido was spotted chilling with his third baby mama Chioma in the usual loved up manner they were known for before their breakup surfaced online. Chioma, popularly known as Chef Chi, was also recently spotted at one of Davido's concerts in Lagos wearing the customized 30BG diamond necklace embossed with her name and 002 at the back, a gift from Davido himself. The Chivido fans have been giddy about their reunion, especially because of the 002 on Chioma's necklace, which they say signifies that Davido considers her as his next in command since he is popularly known as 001. Chioma's pendant tells the rest. Although Chef Chi has been acting all camera shy ever since their comeback, but it kind of seems as if she is codedly expecting the world to know that she is back with her man. And yep, that appears to have worked out as Davido's first baby mama, Sophia Momodu, immediately unfollowed Davido on Instagram. And guess what? He unfollowed her right back.
Ajay, keep your bar. Don't come touching me. Don't come touching me.
Music lovers are not impressed with Tiwa Savage's recently released track Cuckoo Fun featuring international music artist Major Lazer. The self-styled African bad girl has been promoting the song on her social media for days now, and the comment section is as hot as an oven.
Don't come touching me. This is not why we're here. This is not why we're here.
While a few of her colleagues in the industry commented with the fire emoji, implying that the music is dope. On the other hand,
Fans and commentators condemned her lyrics as sounding infantile. They also threw shades at the celebrities who approve of the song, describing them as hypocritical. Some of the comments read, Timmy_Chase_0 said, "Now fake people day this IG. See as them they hype the song." Also, Shady.Gram commented, "All these celebrities where they send fire emoji, they lie for you." Chipeng Fashion said, "Ino sweeto, hope you are aware," and many more similar comments. The music video, as at 6 days after its release, was yet to garner up to 800,000 views.
Some cool, cool fun. This is no why we're here. Don't come touching me. I'll let you keep your money. I'll let you keep your money.
Nigerian singer and Buga crooner Kiss Daniel has acquired a duplex. With the proceeds he made out of the 2022 global storming song Buga, he shared the clips of the building on his Instagram page with a caption that reads, "What a year. Have always wanted to have a house beside the waters for my wife and kids. So God and the best fans in the world helped me. Hashtag Buga."
You get it? If you don't get it, forget about it.
That's it on Entertainment News. Do follow us on all our social media platforms.
Should I call you a fan of Clicklight, a fan of NTA?
Well, yes, I should be, because I'm glad to be patriotic.
Because you're wearing the white, I'm rocking
the white. Yeah, you're rocking the white. I think I'll just... Oh,
okay, you have to drop
on. Oh, the only thing is I'm supposed to be green, white, green, but let's make do with this. Okay, so you just saw Tiwa Savage's new release, and you know, here we are still in the spirit of independence, and a lot of people have been trying to go back in time, you know, about how music was back in the 60s, and then juxtaposing with the kind of sound we have. We've seen Amapiano now take over the likes of the Fela's kind of Afrobeats, the high life we used to know. So what's your opinion on that?
Well, music is it transcends over time, and it reflects the society we live in.
Yeah.
You know, it's that kind of a moral compass. If you listen to the music of from anywhere, you can determine what's happening there, you know. Listen to that.
Okay.
You know, like if you look at Nigeria, we've come a long way. You know, from the 60s, the life was easier. We had fewer news. Not just BBC, maybe it was America, maybe it was just the few news that could filter across. That's what we're hearing.
Yeah.
So we based most of our awareness on those things. That, you know, like people understand. But now there's so much information. There's information everywhere. On the phone, everywhere. Everybody's talking about everything. We are all talking about two different things and all that. People are talking about what happened in Australia, everywhere else. So when you look at music here, you wouldn't just talk about Amapiano and all that. You know that we've come a long way. At some point, it was Makosa. Everywhere was Makosa Garden, Makosa this, Makosa
true,
that.
True.
At some point, it came up to be Ghanaian music. We are doing Azonto.
Yes.
At some point. So everybody has to have his own flag fly at some point.
You know, I picked something from what you said. You said also music kind of tells you what is happening. You can tell what is happening in the country by, you know, the lyrics. And so you see Tiwa Savage saying, "Alaji, keep your money, keep your hands down, don't touch me." So maybe that's what, is that what is happening? Okay, so you got that right. I mean, it's really fun hanging with you. What are you drinking? Okay, don't tell us.
It looks like apple juice.
It looks like apple juice. Let's leave it with apple juice. Well, let's go on from music into fashion, beauty pageants. This one was not, you know, about glamour. It was not about beauty. The Miss Intelligence Nigeria was about the beauty of the mind, organized by NTA's TV Enterprise and SRTV. The first edition of the Miss Intelligence Nigeria featured 18 contestants drawn from different parts of the country. It was refreshingly different. This wasn't the characteristic slay and glam of beauty pageants, but as the title implied, the Miss Intelligence Nigeria focused on the brains of the girls and not their bodies.
As we all know, beauty, hair is the beauty of a woman. We have all kinds of weavons. Our business is to render all services, all cleaning services, such as washing, laundry.
The financial cost to implement this business is 500,000 naira.
These are the contestants in a battle of wits, pitching their business ideas to the judges and audience. They are young, inexperienced, and a bit jittery. But their zeal made a positive mark on the audience, made up of iconic personalities from the public and private sector. The 18 contestants, representing various states, pitched business ideas in areas such as fashion, food, laundry services, technology, agriculture, and skill acquisition, among others. They sought to attract financing for their respective business ideas.
I'm seeking support from all the organizations and individuals to please support me to build this ground. Thank you.
Our professional is actually seeking for a fund of 10 million naira to open, which
the immediate feedback was positive, as some of the guests took interest and promised to dive in.
There's a lot more of work to be done on the girls, a little more of a training on the real essence of a business plan. Business plan must contain the name of the business, your location, your budget. There is no plan without an amount. And we've seen a few of the contestants that have come to mention their business in an understandable manner, and then with an amount to go with it. I'm particularly interested in the FCT and then the Rejoice and a few other contestants. I would like to meet them maybe after the show. And then these girls will grow better with mentorship.
Just a few of them presented a business plan with the cost, with where the location is going to be and what they are going to do with the money, and even encouraged us to invest so we can make money. So it's a process. I wasn't really expecting them to be, you know, 100% ready to give a business plan, but they did very well.
And that is why I say, to the embarrassment of a lot of people, that other people say what a man can do, a woman can do better and all of that, and people go arguing, is it true? And I say to them, the opposite is very true. What a woman can do, a man cannot do. It's from some of the presentations you're seeing, you see that these girls, because they're encouraged and motivated, they're believing in themselves, and from their presentations you can see that they're venturing into things that nobody ever thought they could do. Some girl upstage said she wants to do electrical material sales.
So I tell you what, at events like this, the best place to feel the pulse of the audience is at the back. Paul is seated beside me and I want to feel his pulse and really get a clear perspective of his assessment of the girl's presentation. So Paul, what's your assessment of the girl's presentation?
I must commend them. They presented well, but some of their presentation was like a copyright.
How would you have had them actually prepare?
Some of them, they do not do research.
Basically, some of them knew what they came for, while some, it was like they were ignorant of what they came for. Because I believe in such kind of gathering, you can meet your helper here. You can meet somebody who would support your business, who would want to go into partnership.
I'll be training the uniform men and also fixing up CCTV cameras in strategic areas in Nigeria, and also robotics, artificial things, so that all the insecurities can be seen in ICT.
I never expected something like this could come out of a pageant. I'm quite impressed. And for the fact that it is called Miss Intelligence, what would you expect?
It was not all battle of wits, as there was some entertainment featuring a chubby version of Michael Jackson. There was also presentation of awards. Mrs. Choma Uzodinma, wife of Imo State Governor, got the Award of Excellence, while Girl Child Ambassador Award was presented to the chairman of the event, Felix Jansen Osakwe, former Director General of the NTA, Malam Yakubu Ibn Mohammed, and General Manager of the NTA Entertainment, Tenny Ajayi, got the Media Icon Award.
I also dedicate this award to NTA, because if not for NTA, I wouldn't have had the very capable platform on which I've been able to perform over the years. I dedicate this award to women. They are survivors, they are winners, they are icons in the society, in spite of the fact that, you know, the ground is not level.
However, the climax of the day was the announcement of winners of the contest. Ruth Amarachi, who represented Taraba State, emerged second runner-up and received 300,000 naira, while the first runner-up was Josephine Obodo, representing Adamawa State. She got 500,000 naira. Susan Abdul from Kogi State, representing Anambra State, took the top prize as winner of the 2022 Miss Intelligence Nigeria. She became an instant millionaire as she was bestowed with a prize of 1 million naira.
That was one of a kind. Moving from beauty pageant to movies. Nollywood as the Nigerian film industry has been making waves globally with its culture-themed movies, among others. This has been driving the annual event tagged Nollywood in Hollywood by Osei Oyemedon. It is usually a platform to celebrate and dive into the narratives of our country. For about 2 years now, Nigerians in the diaspora, movie buffs and cinema audiences in Los Angeles have been getting to see indigenous Nigerians movies showcased in Hollywood at the event tagged Nollywood in Hollywood. It is considered to be one of Nigeria's biggest film cultural festivals in the US. COVID-19 set it back for a while, but the event bounced back with the 2022 edition, attracting movie lovers to the screening of two Nigerian movies. The evening kicked off with the usual glitz and glamour of the red carpet. The two movies were screened over 2 days, starting with a movie by Daniel Ademilokan titled Gone, a family drama about an unlucky boxer trying to mend his life and family. On the second night, the movie Juju Stories, a three-part anthology filled dwelling on modern-day Juju stories, rooted in Nigerian folklore and urban legend, was screened.
Turning to yams after picking cash from sidewalks.
It got the audience engrossed.
Those stories, I can relate to all of them because it was like, you know, these are stories that we heard of growing up, but then seeing it dramatized, oh my God. My favorite story was the yam story. Because I know when we're growing up in Nigeria, they tell us, hey, if you're growing up, don't collect money from anybody, don't collect food, you see anything on the floor, don't pick it up. And you know, I know there was a story they told us one time that someone picked some money and they turned to yam. But then seeing it as a movie, it's crazy.
Such a great event. We need to build bridges. I think people, there's so much that people don't know. People don't know anything about the continent, about Nigeria, about Hollywood. And one thing I loved about this film, like I said, was like it put you in this space. Like you saw how Lagos was. You saw how like different places were. So
in the chilled atmosphere, the guests certainly had a great deal of fun.
You guys love what? Walking? How many like strolling by the beach? Hand in hand with just loved ones? Have you ever heard about African students walking 20 miles to school every day or 20 miles back? Walking is not romantic for me. I've suffered. Walking represents suffering. So if you're later African, let's go around in a drop top. Is the same effect, you know what I'm saying? My legs are tired. There's mileage on my legs, you understand what I'm saying? Like a Toyota. So until we start telling our stories, you will not understand where we're coming from.
The event brought Nollywood into focus and the impact it has on the community.
Just being able to piece this together and combine both worlds, because sometimes people always say Hollywood and Nollywood, apples and oranges, we get it.
Right.
But being able to make both worlds merge and meet here, I think is a remarkable thing.
I was so happy and thrilled to be a part of the Nollywood in Hollywood, because I think a lot of people in Hollywood aren't aware of the major impact that Nigerian filmmakers and actors and actresses have in this community. So an event like this is just wonderful to be able to have them out and have people shine a spotlight on these films and these filmmakers.
One of the highlights of this year's edition was the partnership with Hollywood Foreign Press Association and Golden Globes, giving it an enhanced status.
Niger to the world. Now let's come back here to Nigeria. It's been raining cats and dogs for months now. But should that be an excuse not to get up, dress up, and slay? Let's hear from a fashionista.
Hello guys, my name is Kelsey Wokuma. I'm the creative director of Kelsey's Threads That Trends Wardrobe. And I'm here to tell you about five must-haves you should have in your wardrobe in this raining season. We all know the rains are here again and it's been raining heavily here in the city of Port Harcourt, and I'm pretty sure we've not even seen sunlight for quite some time, and I'm sure it's the same thing over there where you are. Sit tight, you can grab a pen and a piece of paper and pay attention to those five items I'm about to point out to you. The number one item that makes you look charged up to take on the rain whenever it comes, you sure don't want to be stranded at some point going for that appointment or that meeting, who knows? The first thing you need is an umbrella. Not just any kind of umbrella you need. I personally love the colorful umbrellas with the whole vintage design all over it, and I'm always sharp. So all you got to do is break the boredom, maintain your fashionable look with a good looking umbrella. Number two, you need a jacket. You know, while the umbrella provides you the whole shelter, one way you can maintain your look, not getting to damage your good looking outfit you have, throw on some jacket, throw on a jacket, throw on a blazer, just put it on. That provides you another form of shelter and you don't get to ruin your good looking, that awesome looking cloth your wonderful designer has designed for you and you've used to step out of that beautiful occasion. Number three, you need a sweatshirt. Yeah, with the rain comes the cold. Yeah, the umbrella provides you with shelter, the blazer covering that outfit. Yeah, cool. How about the cold? You need to beat the cold. So you beat the cold with a sweatshirt. Number four on my list is a muffler or a desert scarf, as some will call it. You know, desert scarves are always handy and small, and sure, the best way to enjoy having a desert scarf on or a muffler on is when you know how to style it, like wrapping it around your neck stylishly. You know, it's always going to be on fleek having that on your outfit. Just try it out. The last but not the least on my list of five is your own choice of footwear. Personally, I've shifted all my leathers and my foamy shoes to one corner. What I put on now in this rainy season are all my rubber footwear. My slides, rubber, my shoes, rubber. I don't want to ruin that good looking shoe.
Under my umbrella, Ella,
Don't make me sound like
Jesus. Yeah, I'm telling you, you know, right? I actually love the dynamism the fashionista brought to the top five, because, you know, you hardly get to hear the fashionistas tell you, you know, you have to get an umbrella. And trust me, he was apt with that.
Yeah, I like the fact that he spoke about the rubber footwear, you know, going out this time. Some people forget not to put that. They go with normal shoes and they get soaked.
Yeah, I think that is a must-have. Yeah. I mean, for some time now, I've not been using any... you know, leather or what do they call those other, you know, materials? It's all, I've been going out with Crocs, except right now because it's not raining. Mm. But I have my Crocs, like, you know,
so
on standby.
She goes out with her Crocs everywhere.
True that.
Everywhere.
True that. So make sure you get your umbrella and your Crocs, and then whatever you're wearing definitely is gonna stay on point, stay intact. But to round off the Independence edition, back to the question: what have you done for your country?
Movies on my mind, music on my mind, fashion and style on my mind.
And to add to that very quickly, Click Light on my mind. Week in, week out.
Yep.
It's been an interesting ride on this week's episode of the program. Until we come your way next week.
Keep watching at the same station, same time. I am Butu Miller.
And I'm Ekemini Williams. Salute. I think you're a really sweet person. I think you're, really lovable.